You know, I just want to say this. Sometimes the cover-up is worse than the act. A few weeks ago, Mayor Duggan was found to have his staff members deleting emails regarding the Make Your Date Foundation, the city's involvement with the Make Your Date Foundation. It was proven, and it was not argued, that the mayor's staff people deleted emails regarding Make Your Date and the city's involvement with it. The mayor came up with the excuse that it was okay for them to delete the emails because their hearts were in the right place. My senior staff, Alexis Wiley, his chief of staff, decided to have underlings delete emails to protect them from a guy named Bob Carmack, who is waging a battle with the mayor. Okay, the mayor got on TV and said, my staff will not be punished. They will receive training for deleting government emails during an investigation, actually prior to an investigation. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, if this had happened to Mayor Archer, what do you think the press would be doing? If this had happened to Kwame Kilpatrick, if he had done the same thing, what do you think the press would have been doing? If this had happened to Dave Bing, what do you think the press would be doing? Instead, the only thing we've heard about this, and editorial-wise, is from the Detroit News. It's a horrible double standard. And Mayor Duggan has to be taken to task. I mean, he could have done this a whole different way and saved a whole lot of problems. He could have said, I'm disciplining them, I'm giving them time off, I'm not giving them time off, I'm suspending them for a week, and just let them go off and come back. Instead, he says, arrogantly, no, they did the right thing. Their hearts were in the right place because they wanted to protect them from this guy, Bob Carmack, this little hillbilly from southern Wayne County, western, southwest Wayne County. Really, Mayor Duggan? Come on. And really, Detroit media? If that had been Kwame, what would you be doing right now? When we come back, we're going to talk about our most precious asset, our elders, our parents, our aunts, our uncles. We're going to talk about taking care of them in their later years. We'll be right back. Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. One of the things I hate to see is an elderly person go into a nursing home. Nursing homes often are funky. Nursing home staff definitely doesn't love the parent like we love our parent. It's never good enough. You know, we need our parents to stay at home. I want to introduce you today to Amada Senior Healthcare. Did I get that right?
Amada Senior Care.
See that? Yeah. Amada Senior Care.
Yes.
But there's a lot of health involved.
Yes.
And that's why I added the health in there.
Okay.
A lot of my friends, my parents are both deceased, but a lot of my friends now have elderly parents, and they're wondering for a solution. They're looking for a solution outside of the nursing home. How is Amada Senior Care different?
What we do is we send our caregivers, we have caregivers that we send into the home to help the clients or the patients with their activities of daily living. That's bathing, dressing, meal prep. We do lighthouse cleaning, help with toileting. So these are the things that we send our caregivers in to do, which sometimes if that help is not there in a home, that's when the families may start looking for a facility.
I see trucks with wraps over them all throughout the city, and it's Boo Boo the Fool's home health care service. What's the difference that Amada brings?
Sure. We are part of a franchise. We're Amada Senior Care. The franchise started out in California. myself and my business partner, Greg Hines, who have known each other for 30 years, we decided to do this. We decided to do this because we wanted to do something a little larger than what we were doing before. We were doing pharmaceutical device sales. And my experience was that I saw my father-in-law who was ill, and he was ill for a few mm-hmm. years. And I saw the care that he got from my mother-in-law. And I thought, well, I think every elderly person who is sick needs this type of care. If the family can't provide it, I would probably want to be there to provide that care. And so what makes us a little different is that all our employees are trained, well-trained. We try to fit that caregiver with the client, personality-wise. So we place someone into a home, and it may not be the best fit initially. We always try to get it right the first time, but if not, we would send another caregiver out there.
What type of quality assurance does the franchisor demand of you?
Okay.
Because this is the big issue I have with home health care companies.
Sure.
All right, here in Detroit. Go ahead.
Yes. Yeah. So we are an A-rated franchise. And that's because all our caregivers work for us. They're not independent contractors, so they're all W-2 employees. Mm-hmm. We have all the insurances that are required. Mm-hmm. So we have our liability insurance, workman comp insurance. So this is things that families are not going to have to be concerned about. Generally, that's in the back of their head when they're trying to find a caregiver, but they've got to be aware of this because you would want a company that has those, I guess, security of having that insurance. So a lot of the companies may not have those things, especially they may hire caregivers and they're independent contractors and they're not employees of the company. And so if that's the case, they're relying on that caregiver, that independent contractor to have those insurance, and probably most times they don't have that.
Okay. Yeah. When we come back with your partner, I'm going to discuss how this thing is actually paid for.
Sure.
Okay. If people are interested in learning more about Amada, what number should they call?
Our phone number is 248-237-6377.
All right, Mr. Emanuel, I want to thank you for joining us this morning. My friends are really worried about it, you know?
Sure.
Because you don't know what to do. Right. You want your parent taken care of.
Yes.
But you don't want them just sitting in some idle place.
Correct.
Where there's not an atmosphere of love like the home.
Right.
Thank you very much.
Right. Thank you for having me.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
When I was a young girl, I made rounds at Harper Hospital with my dad. And being able to see the love that he was giving, I knew this was something special. DMC is where I started my journey in medicine, and it's where I'm living my journey in medicine. It's where I came back home. DMC Harper University Hospital is nationally acclaimed for research and teaching. And to me, it is still the home of medical care in Detroit. And I'm proud of that legacy. DMC, a community built on care.
Every year, DTE Energy helps its business customers save about $40 million on their energy bills. We perform over 1,800 free on-site business energy consultations and provide hundreds of money-saving incentives. Why? Because we're committed to helping Michigan's businesses and its people thrive. DTE Energy. Know your own power.
Every success story starts with a spark of curiosity, of wanting more. Wayne County Community College District has more than 120 academic and career training programs and support to help you every step of the way. From registration to financial aid to career placement, find your spark and get on a path to your best life. Register today.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're talking about senior healthcare this morning. I have Gregory Hines from Amada Senior Care with me. Your partner in our last segment got me feeling good
sure.
about Amada Senior Care and the home healthcare services they provide. How much does something like this cost?
Well, there are different ways to take care of the cost, to pay for the cost. Mm-hmm. Typically, it's private pay because most medical insurances, Steve, don't pay for it. But there are other ways to pay for it in addition to out of your pocket. There are community resources like the Veterans Administration. They pay for costs for vets, for certain veterans who meet their criteria.
Wait a minute. You're telling me certain veterans can do this?
Yes, that's a benefit. That's another benefit that the VA provides for veterans. Of course, as my business partner said, that typically the criteria is that they need assistance with activities of daily living, bathing, dressing, and some of the other things, in order for them to stay at home. So the VA pays for it for certain veterans. Long-term care insurance mm-hmm. pays for it. There's a policy that you can take out. Typically you do it when you're younger, mm-hmm. but it allows you to subsidize the cost of certain different care. One is in-home care. Then there are some programs through federal government or the state of Michigan, some Medicaid waiver programs that take care of it. And then there are other organizations that provide some assistance within home care. Mm-hmm.
And so, do you have to have a person on every day, or do they come in every other day? I mean, it just depends on the level of need?
Yeah, that's what we do. We try to fit your needs. So we've got clients who are very acute in terms of their health and the requirements for their health needs. And so those might be folks who have care potentially 24 hours a day. But we've got other people that we take care of who only might need assistance maybe 2-3 days a week for a few hours. So we try to fit whatever the need is that you have. But the reality is that if there is a need, whether it's 2 or 3 hours a day, there is still that need there. And that's when we come in to take care of whatever the need is.
We have viewers in Wayne, Oakland, Macomb, St. Clair, Lenawee. We're all over the place, especially
sure.
with Hulu.
Sure.
So you're bigger than Oakland County.
We are. We're franchised, as Kevin mentioned. So we cover, right now we're covering most of Metro Detroit. We go into Oakland County, we go into Macomb County, we go certainly into Wayne County. We've got a second location as well, which covers part of Washtenaw County. So we go into parts okay. of Ann Arbor and Ypsilanti area.
Mm-hmm. What happens if a person's parent starts to digress, mm-hmm. do you stay in contact with their medical provider? What do you do? How does that interface go?
That's a really important question, and here's the reason that that's so important. Because when you think of in-home care, a lot of times, Steve, what you think about is a caregiver coming into the home and helping you get bathed and dressed and doing those kind of things, and then it's reported back to the family that your mom or your dad or your loved one was taken care of. But the reality of in-home care is that there's a huge population of seniors out there. The silver tsunami is almost here, and that's
silver tsunami.
Well, it just very simply means that in the year 2030, a fifth of the population will be older than 65. So we'll have more seniors in 2030 than we will have children. That's never happened in the history of America. And what oftentimes you see at that age is that more people have diabetes, more people are obese, more people have arthritis. So our caregivers go in, they help the family by making sure that these diabetics take their medicine. They go in and help with cooking and changing dietary items so that they're cooking better, so that there may be a weight loss. They do range of motion to help with some arthritic concerns. So it's more, and then we report that back to not just the children, but also the medical providers. And we help in a couple different ways like that. And we're also able to report this back to the medical providers and the family. And it just helps across the board.
So it's not just a standalone thing.
Well, it's so multivaried in terms of what we're able to do for the patients that we take care of, that it is not just a standalone thing.
Okay. Once again, if somebody wants to learn more about Amada Senior Care, how do they do that?
Sure. They just give us a call at 248-237-6377. Again, that's 248-237-6377. Or they can go to our website, which is Amada, A-M-A-D-A, FarmingtonHills.com. And Amada is just very simply a word that means loved or beloved. And that's our philosophy of how we take care of people.
Okay. Mr. Hines, thank you very much for joining us this morning. Ladies and gentlemen, we come back, we're going to talk about the ultimate destination. Funeral time. We'll talk to you in a minute.
What first sparked your curiosity? Drove you to learn more? To be better? To achieve things? And go places you couldn't have imagined before? At WCCCD, you can discover or rediscover your spark for learning and find your path to your best life. Want more? Start here. Register today.
After receiving a delinquent property tax bill for the two lots connected to my home, I was concerned. I didn't even know that I had a past due bill. I went down to the Wayne County Treasurer's Office, and the staff worked with me to keep my property out of foreclosure.
My property taxes became delinquent after I fell behind on my bills. Treasurer Sabree and his staff came to the town hall in my city and provided information about resources available to help me. At the meeting, I found out about payment plan options.
Let us help you. Our goal is zero owner-occupied properties getting foreclosed and going to the auction. Come down to our office at 400 Monroe in downtown Detroit on the fifth floor. Call 313-224-5990 during our normal business hours from 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. and until 6:30 p.m. on Wednesdays. Or email taxinfo@waynecounty.com for assistance. Take the first step. Contact our office today.
It worked for us.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. Today we're talking about our parents. We've been talking about senior care in our first half, and now the inevitable, which is death. I have Stephen Kemp, the owner of the Kemp Funeral Home here in Southfield, Michigan. And Mr. Kemp, welcome.
Thank you.
And you've got a smile on your face.
Absolutely, absolutely.
You know, when I used to, remember Old Man Fritz?
Yes.
Fritz Funeral Home?
Whenever he would, MK, yeah.
Yes, whenever he would greet me, he would greet me and put his hand up my arm like he was measuring me.
Right.
You're not shaking my hand today.
Absolutely.
We're a while from that.
Right, right.
But beyond all that, when it's time for the end, whether it's a timely end or untimely end, how does it work? A family comes in, they're grieving. What's the first thing you do when they come to Kemp Funeral Home?
Primarily for me and my staff was listening. Mm-hmm. We don't pull out a pen or pencil and take the information first. I just want to listen to the family, what their concerns are, what they want to do, and listen to see who the person that passed away was about. Then we start doing the planning. And the planning is done specifically by the family. All I do is use my professional skills to help them make a decision on what kind of disposition or what kind of service that they want. I think that's the most important thing is being a great funeral director is listening because they want to celebrate the homegoing of their loved one. And I think instead of us telling them, you tell us and we'll give them you the tools to work with to help them make it a better disposition.
So you've listened and then you take them through the burial options?
Burial or cremation, because cremation now is actually equal burial as of 2015. We do actually more cremations now than we do burials.
Well, let's start off with the cremations.
Sure.
What is the average, you can just give me a range,
sure,
the average cost of a cremation?
Well, the average, you know, that's an interesting question, because what I tell people
is
cremation is disposition. It's not necessarily what I call a destination. So what do I mean by that? You certainly can have a full service with visitation. You can have a memorial service, or you can have no service at all. So when I tell people, the typical range is $1,500, or you can go as high as $10,000, depending on what you may want or what you want planned for your loved one. And what people forget is a lot of times is the disposition of the cremated remains may go into a cemetery, you may dispose of it in a lake somewhere, or the person's favorite place, or in what we call a niche. It's typically at a cemetery. So it all varies depending on what the family wants and needs for their loved one.
Let's step back a second.
Sure.
You can actually legally dispose of the ashes in a lake?
Well, we don't say that you have to get permission. Obviously, if they own the lake, own a piece of the lake, they certainly can. But a lot of times you have to get EPA permission or sometimes permission from the persons or the community that owns the lake.
Okay. I say that because I've left instructions for me to be cremated and thrown overboard from my boat if it survives me.
Right.
And I just wondered.
Absolutely. You do have to get permission, and there is a permit. In some destinations, there are some permits that you have to get, but generally it's not very easy to do.
At the end, when the cremation is complete, the disposition is complete, I noticed that you have several different types of urns and even a charm bracelet to hold the ashes.
Yes, actually, this week we're making one. Family wants to, you can actually take cremains and they put high pressure on. You can actually make a piece of jewelry out of the actual cremated remains. You can put jewelry inside. You put the cremated remains inside the jewelry.
You're telling me that I can make jewelry out of my deceased father?
Absolutely. You can make a kiosk. You can make anything you want to. Now, pieces of art, actually, have been done with cremated remains.
Dad, I'm not making a piece of jewelry out of you.
Okay.
But that actually happens.
It does. And that's how our service has evolved from the traditional burial, what people see now. There are, you know, we're sort of caskets now. Now we're doing different kinds of urns. And urns don't look like themselves anymore as well, either. So it all depends on what the consumer wants.
Okay. When we come back, I want to talk about the importance of preparing your wishes for your family.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, like coming in to the funeral home saying, well, he wants an oak casket, you know, and all of this stuff.
Sure.
You know, writing it down.
Yes.
As part of the
will. I think that's the most important thing.
So. Okay.
All right.
Ladies and gentlemen, we come back. It's more on that final disposition. Disposition, right?
That's correct.
Okay, with Stephen Kemp, the head of the Kemp Funeral Home.
Attention veterans and families of veterans. If you are elderly or disabled and need help with activities of daily living, you might qualify for a free in-home caregiver. Amada Senior Care works with vets to help you get qualified. Call Amada Senior Care 248-237-6377. We match you with a highly qualified non-medical caregiver. Amada is an A-plus rated agency. Enjoy a better quality of life. Call for your free consultation 248-237-6377.
Kemp Funeral Home, where lasting memories are uniquely yours. The beautiful chapel holds nearly 300 guests.
Our services are as unique as your life and your loved one's life.
Plus, a spacious lobby and a separate repast parlor. Kemp Funeral Home in Southfield is helping families prepare before their time of need by offering free monthly seminars on all aspects of funeral planning. Call today for a free consultation, 248-702-5367.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're at the Kemp Funeral Home in Southfield. My guest is Stephen Kemp. Before I continue, I am remiss. You've won a prestigious award amongst funeral directors.
Correct.
Tell me about that award.
The National Funeral Directors Association, actually on Monday, coming up on the 28th, will get awarded our second year in a row of the Pursuit of Excellence Award. And what you have to do for that, basically, is it is about community service. It's about service to our clients as well as their community and be involved in actually in the community. We have to write essays. We have to present different community organizations that we do or things that we do in the community as well. And it's reviewed, it's peer reviewed by funeral directors around the nation. And they select those funeral homes to be awarded the Pursuit of Excellence.
That's awesome.
It is.
Mr. Kemp, I've had the unfortunate duty to bury two of my friends within the last year. And they both had massive oak caskets.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so much so that their other friends, didn't really work out, so they couldn't handle the girth of these fellows.
Correct.
But they both had requested this.
Yes.
In advance. How important is it for a family to come in or a person to have their final wishes written down?
I think it's very important to get exactly what you want as, you know, if it's your demise, exactly have the service that you want to have.
Mm-hmm.
And you can pre-plan for those, you can prepay into a trust, and you can select your units ahead of time, units and meaning caskets, whether you want oak or whether you want mahogany, like what you see behind you, or metal.
Mm-hmm.
And it's important also to tell somebody that loves you or their next of kin to also help you pre-plan. There is now, in the last 5 years, we now have something we call funeral representative law, so it doesn't necessarily have to be your next of kin.
Mm-hmm.
You can get a paper and have it signed, and you can have someone you select to help you do those funeral arrangements without interference of somebody else.
When the person comes in, person's family comes into the funeral home, do you select the cemetery or does the family select that?
Remember I told you first when we talked about listening. Whatever the family wants, they may want a specific area, a specific geographic area, and we listen, we suggest. Mm-hmm. If they already have plots, typically they go where the family's been before. Mm-hmm. For instance, like Elmwood Cemetery, a lot of people go there. Mm-hmm. And we help them make that selection, and we kind of paved the way for that.
You mentioned that cremations were now on par with burials?
That's correct.
Wow. So what about the cost differential? Is one cheaper than the other? Less expensive than the other?
In a way, I would say yes. Cremation generally is less expensive because the average cost of a cemetery piece of it is about $2,500. And cremation is about 10% of that, $250. So the disposition can vary depending on what you want.
Okay. So we've talked about an elderly person coming in who's planned their, you know, who has planned their disposition. Mm-hmm. What about the thing that grips Detroit the most, young people being murdered on the street? Mm-hmm. What happens when a family has lost a young loved one due to violence?
Well, that's a different set of circumstances. Again, first of all, the uncertainty of it. And secondly, what we're finding out, people our age, typically had insurance. Mm-hmm. What we find out, younger people typically do not have insurance, mm-hmm. and they have to do this GoFundMe thing, or families are not mm-hmm. prepared financially to take on that burden. And that's what I find out most of the things, is that people just don't have insurance, and they want a specific kind of burial or a specific kind of service, and really can't, they have to raise the money to do that. So I'm finding that more and more with our young people. Unfortunate, that's unfortunate, but it happens. So. We're actually involved in the community trying to prevent that, but mm-hmm. You know, it's a tough thing to do at times.
All right, Mr. Kemp, there are also people in this world that are like me, that are single, and they probably will never have children and to bury them and all that stuff.
Sure.
But like me, I'm buying a dog in a few months.
Okay.
And my dog, I will probably outlive my dog. All right, what do you do for pets?
What we do for pets, we help facilitate pets. Now, we don't have a crematory on site because we haven't been zoned for it quite yet. But we certainly can, people can call us and we can recommend. There are services that do pet cremations, and that's pretty much 99% of what we do is help people facilitate those things. But the urns, and particular designer urns, we have here on the premises.
Actually, for the pet, people, and you put the pet's picture on it?
Oh, yeah. People do a lot of things. They treat their pets better than sometimes they do humans.
Wow.
So, yeah, they do. Put their picture on it. I have one bronze. You know, all my pets are mm-hmm. in our showroom with their collars and mm-hmm. things like that, because we have three dogs at home too. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, Mr. Kemp, I want to thank you for inviting us in this week.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me.
And if you got to make a final decision, I like how you listen.
Sure.
I like how you listen.
Yeah.
And so if my family comes to me and said he wants to be thrown over the side, you'll take care of me, right?
And I was Christina's teacher, too, so.
Really?
I was Christina's teacher many years ago. So.
Okay, well, let me shake your hand.
All right. You will
now,
shake
Now, this
hand.
Is how Fritz does it. Fritz does it like that.
I know Jimmy.
Anyway.
Jimmy was a good
ladies
friend.
Ladies and gentlemen, yeah. We'll be back next week, and it'll be under happier circumstances.
The preceding program was paid for by Ronin America, DMC, Wayne County Treasurer's Office, DTE, WCCCD, the Center for Functional Health, Kemp Funeral Home, Amada Senior Care, Dr. Shauna Diggs, and Mike's Fresh Market.